Good morning. That short speech will be dedicated to the students of Erasmus students, who decided to carry on the cycle of plant and animal protection in urban areas. I know that me and Professor Piotr Dąbrowski, we will have she students, very charmful ones, who decided to take part at that course. That speech, outdoor activity in the protected areas, is linked directly to the topic of the course, but not in the whole. I would like to present you the forms of nature protection in Poland, in comparison to other countries, to the world, let's say, and what are the unique forms of environmental protection in Poland, and what kind of outdoor activities are of a special impact to the environment. So let's begin with the definition of the protected area. It's a clearly defined geographical space, recognized, dedicated, and managed through legal or effective means to achieve the long term conservation. It's very important that the conservation of nature at that areas should be long term, and alongside with nature and associated ecosystems, services, and also what is also of special means, cultural values of that. Of that area, and what forms of environmental protection we have achieved in Poland. We have as follow: the national parks, the nature reserves, the landscape parks, the protected landscape areas, the nature on Natura 2000 areas, the nature monuments, the documentation sites, the ecological areas, landscape or nature complexes, or plants, animals, and fungi, species protection. So other idea of nature protection, and how it does look like in numbers. We've got 23 national parks, almost 1,500 nature reserves, more than 100 landscape parks, about 400 of protected landscape areas. And in the case of nature or Natura 2000 areas, we have more than 1,000 areas as a whole, amongst almost 150 are the areas protected in the case of birds, so-called special protection sites, about 850 special sites of conservation, protected on other forms because of the presence of other valuable organisms, other valuable species, not birds. So I would explain it later. We've got about 31,000 of monuments of nature, almost 200 of documentation sites, almost thousand of ecological areas and more than 250 landscape nature complexes. It's all about the form of protection, the complexes, the areas, and as well, for sure, we protect also the species, the plants, animals, and fungi, spongy species of special values in the terms of biology. So we have more than 700 plant species protected, more than 300 fungi species, and almost 800 animal species protected. And let's follow the forms of protection in every kind of that area, and let's begin with the national parks. You recognize we've got 23 national parks, and the basic item of that form of protection is the area. National park should cover no less than 1,000 hectares, and it's the site, it's a complex where natural elements, environmental elements, are protected, as well as the landscape and cultural values. It's very important. The national parks should protect not just the nature, but also the culture, the biodiversity, but also the cultural, cultural heritage of the region. So it's the, let's say, cooperation between the nature and the human human being. Moreover, the national parks should serve as the source of restoration of the natural habitats, plants, animals, and fungi. What's about the nature reserves? It's a little bit slidey form of nature protection. The natural reserves cover the areas preserved in the natural, but they may be slightly changed in that total state ecosystem. The refugees maybe just the plants, just the animals, just the fungi, also the elements of natural environment, very important from the point of view of their scientific, cultural, and landscape values. As you can say, this is the seaside of Algarve in Portugal. It is just the case, just the example of such such area being protected by as a nature reserve. Landscape parks. We are going down, let's say, with the forms of the forms of protection. So landscape parks cover the areas protected on the account of particular partial environmental, scientific, cultural, and landscape values. And they serve to, basically, they serve to populars, to share the scientific knowledge amongst the people in the conditions, in the terms of sustainable developments. They should they should present the forms of combining the usage of the landscape by nature and by humans. They should show how it's possible to share the environment between those two basic sources of usage. Another form of slidey protected areas, so protected landscape areas, they cover the valuable distinctive landscapes, diverse ecosystems, and valuable areas which possess possibility to meet connection between the tourism, the usage by the land, and leisure, the pleasure of usage it by humans, as well play the important roles in the corridors of immigration and the wildlife corridors. Very important nowadays in modern terms are the nature or Natura 2000 areas. What does it mean, Nature 2000, Natura 2000? It's the international world unique enterprise which is designed to protect the biological diversity in terms of Europe, in the terms of all the continent. All the European countries are designed to protect about 10% of the total area most valuable from the environmental condition in the form of Nature 2000, and the form of protection should be constant. There are unique rules and regulation on that area, specific form of rules and regulation to protect different forms of the environment, also ones connected with human activities, because human is also the element, the man is also the element of the environment. So birds, reptiles, amphibians, fish, but also the man. Also the man activity should be protected in the form of Nature 2000. Other case of environmental protection are the nature monuments. Individual, single objects of animate and inanimate nature, of the group, of the clusters, of particular environmental, scientific, but also cultural, historical, or landscape values. For example, high old trees, the clusters of shrubs, the waterfalls, the rocks, the ravines, the caves, almost all the forms of nature, which should be preserved, when should be which are valuable for human sightseeing, for the tourism in the good proper meaning of that of that time. Also, the areas of the slightest importance are ecological areas, landscape, nature, nature complexes. But it's very important for you that in the urban areas, for example in Warsaw, we would very often we should take into account such forms of protecting the landscape. It's clear we have no landscape parks in towns, but the ecological areas, the reserves, the landscape nature complexes, for example, just nearby our university, we've got the Ursynowska slope. It's very, very interesting area in a biological sense, with a lot of valuable plant and animal species. So let's say about plants, animals, and fungi species protection. And in that case, we have our national law and regulation, and we should take into account also the European Union rules and regulation. So we should put the special attention to the endemic endemic species, to the rare species, to the species of the rare ones, once again, but of the special environmental importance, of the specific role in, for example, ecological website. For sure, it demands the knowledge, the biological knowledge, the knowledge about the nature, but it comes with your study. And let's pass to the other aspect of environmental protection, so the human impact on the environment, anthropogenic impact, human anthropogenic excuse me. So it's clear that human activity impacts negatively, destroys the biophysical environment, the biological diversity. The term anthropogenic is treated generally negatively in the biological sense. The first scientist who used the term anthropogenic was Russian, Alexei Pavlov, later it was developed by the Arthur Tenslein. Tenslein was British, and they both treated the human impact on the environment basically as the influence on the community, on the communities, on the climax, communities which are being stated by the evolution. The last of the scientists who developed the term anthropogenic on anthropocene was Paul Crutzen in the 70s of the last century, but he was using the term in the aspect of for sure human activities, but especially the environmental pollution, the chemical, the physicochemical pollution, not just the human impact on the environment. And let's say what kinds of human activities may have the most violent impact on the natural environment. Let's say how it looks like in the case of the modern sports, modern activity. For sure, one of the basic aspects we should take into account is the growing number of human population and the growing intensity of our activity. Let's say 2 million of the human population in last century is not the same that 2 million nowadays. It's not because now that the same number of people move rapidly, would like to change the places to visit to visit various sites, to recognize, to explore the environment. So it's not the case of just the sole number of the human population, but it's the case of our activity, and the growing popularity of various sports, various activities. And let's say follow the question which is I think most important in our case: what kinds of human activities are especially dangerous for natural environment? For sure, you should recognize also other forms of human activities that I will be presenting you. Fishing, for sure. It's a little girl towing the fish. If you say that the fishing is most dangerous for the national environment, we won't be a friend because I'm the fisherman. So I don't like that idea. But quite seriously, for sure, it is the impact for the on the environment. It is the strong influence on the environment, especially if we destroy the surrounding of the water bodies, or when we take the fish. Nowadays, we are witnesses of growing popularity, of growing impact of the trends of so-called no kill or catch and release ideology. So this is the fishing, the mode of fishing where the fishermen release the fish, and it's for sure, in my opinion, worth recommending. horse riding. I think it's this kind of activity hasn't got a lot of negative impact on the on the environment. It is worth recommending, as well as diving. But remember that diving, but no taking the sources of the coral reefs, for example, the spongy, the corals, just diving for diving. Biking, mountain biking especially, it's nothing risky. Nothing risky for the environment, for sure. But what about the golf? The golf seems to be the kind of activity, kind of sport for the nobleman, for the gentleman. But remember that the golf course, the field. For golf playing, it covers a lot of surface, a lot of surface. Sometimes it's in a very valuable environment. For example, in Warsaw, one of the most well-known, I don't know if it's not the only one, the golf course is located in the valley of Wilanówka River, and it's very, very valuable from the environmental point of view. It's a nesting site for many valuable birds, murren, kurt, and the neighborhood, let's say, of the golf course may be very dangerous for the environment. May get a strong impact on the environment. Nordic walking. Oh, that man doesn't mean to be well prepared for Nordic walking, but just for the illustration, is rather environmental friendly kind of environment, as well as mushroom collecting. In the case we do not destroy the environment, so as well as the skin and sailing. But the basic challenge for organized outdoor activity is to minimize the disturbances to the environment, and what's most important in that case, the good, the proper awareness, choosing the right area, right time for peculiar time of for the activity, to choose the good organizer, the thinking suitable administration body to organize the activity, to find the proper shelter, to find the proper place for example, to make the bonfire, to rest. There are all very important items, very important cases for good kinds of outdoor activity. And I'm interesting What are your first reflections after that short speech? We would open Dr. Dombrowski would open the platform and teams, and we would like to get your first reflections about that topic. Thank you very much.